Hi all, welcome back to the course on quantum mechanics. So in this 21st lecture, I'll be introducing what's going to be parity operator. Okay, so an operator is said to be a parity operator if it undergoes or if it transforms the space inversion or the space reflection of the wave function. So consider the ket R is the eigenvector of position operator. Okay, then the parity operator is defined as the parity operator P acting on ket R gives minus ket R. So this is called the space inversion or reflection about origin. So such kind of operator is called parity operator. So if the parity operator act twice on a vector, what would happen? That would be equal to P times ket R. So once you act P on ket R, you will get minus ket R. If you act once again, you will get the ket R. So that means the P square operator is nothing but identity. Okay, the square of the parity operator is identity. So therefore, the eigenvalues of parity operators are plus one or minus one. So these are the two possibility for the eigenvalues of parity operator. Okay, so we can express the definition of parity operator in another way using the wave function. So let psi of R is wave function in position basis. Then the parity operator acting on the psi of R gives psi of minus R. So these are another way of defining the parity operator. Now recall this parity operator has eigenvalue plus one or minus one. So the parity operator can have two the eigen functions. So these eigen functions for the time being, I can write as plus or minus of R, and the corresponding eigen value is plus one or minus one times y plus or minus R. So that means the parity operator acting on phi plus of R gives phi plus of R. So the phi plus is the eigen function corresponding to the eigen value plus one. And the parity operator acting on phi minus of R gives minus phi minus of R. So this phi plus and phi minus, phi plus of R and phi minus of R are eigen functions of parity operator with eigenvalues plus one and minus one respectively. Okay, now we can just consider the eigen function corresponding to the plus one. So the parity operator acting on phi plus of R. So actually it should get phi plus of minus R. By definition, okay, we know that P acting on phi plus gives phi plus. So that means phi plus of minus R should be phi plus of R. Okay, in other words, we can say that this phi plus of R is an even function. So such condition. So if phi plus of minus R equal to phi plus of R is called even function. Now what about the parity operator acting on phi minus of R? So by definition, when the parity operator acting on phi minus of R, it should make an inversion for r. So it should be phi minus of minus r. And according to the definition of phi minus, so the battery operator acting on phi minus gives minus of phi minus of minus phi of r. So it should be minus of phi minus of r. So that means this phi minus of r is an odd function. Okay, or in other ways, we can say that the eigenfunctions of the parity operator is either odd or even. Okay, so it would be either odd function or even function. Now, these functions must be orthogonal because the thing is, this parity operator is Hermitian. So that means if you take the inner product, if you take the inner product phi, the parity operator psi, it is same as inner product psi p phi, the complex conjugate. So p is Hermitian, and therefore the eigen functions or the eigenvectors of parity operators must be orthogonal, corresponding to different eigenvalues. Okay, and the thing is, we know that the p square is identity, or p times p is identity. So it shows that the p inverse, the inverse of parity operator, is that operator itself. Okay, for parity operator, the inverse is same as it, and it is as well as Hermitian. So then we can combiningly, we can write the Hermitian conjugate of parity operator is same as the parity operator, the same as the inverse of the parity operator. Okay, so that's all about the parity operator. And with using parity operator, we can define the even operator and odd operator. So that can also be included in this particular session, even and odd operators. So an operator A is said to be even if the parity operator times A times parity operator gives A. So if this is the case, then A is even operator. And similarly, an operator B is said to be odd operator if the parity operator times B operator times parity operator gives minus B. So this, if this is the case, then B is odd operator. Okay, so that's enough. So we have introduced what is meant by the parity operator. The parity operator gives the space reflection or space inversion of the vectors. So if the parity operator acting on the ket r gives minus ket r, or the parity operator acting on the wave function psi of r gives psi of minus r. Now the important properties of the parity operator is the square of the parity operator is identity operator. So therefore, the possible eigenvalues of the parity operator will be only plus 1 and minus 1. And so then we can show that the corresponding eigenfunctions, it will be either odd function or even function. So the eigen function corresponding to the plus one eigen value would be an even function. So this is this 5 plus is the eigen function. So 5 plus of R is eigen function corresponding to plus 1. And similarly, 5 minus is the eigen function corresponding to the eigen value minus 1. And that is an odd function. So 5 plus is even function, 5 minus is odd function. So it can have two possible eigen functions. So it should be either even or odd function. And we also stated that this the parity operator is a Hermitian operator, so that this dagger gives the same operator itself, and it is self-inverse. The inverse of the parity operator is same as the parity operator. So we can summarize everything with this one statement: the P dagger equal to P inverse for parity operators. Now, using parity operator, we can define the even operator and odd operator. So these are the definition for the even and odd operators. So with this, we have completed the discussion of the parity operator, and we have almost completed the topics of the mathematical formulation of quantum mechanics. So just for the curiosity, we can discuss the representation of the momentum eigen function and the position eigen functions in the next class. Okay, so with that lecture, we'll wind up the discussion of the mathematical formulation of quantum mechanics. So we can, for the time being, we can stop it here. So we'll see in the next lecture. That would be the last session of this particular module. So thanks for watching this video. We'll see you again.